Christmas is coming early. You picked a compelling, amazing night to watch. Team Bala versus Team Vortex scaffold match here tonight.
It's gonna be crazy. Make sure you got your hard hats on and look for the signs that say caution, falling wrestlers.
Oh my god, you picked a good night to watch. Next live wrestling experience is called Crossing the Line. It's Saturday, June 20th at the Colonial Theater, 3522 Stockton Boulevard in Sacramento. Doors at 7, bell time at 7:30. You'd better come.
You're damn right.
Boom! Explosions everywhere. TWF title match at Crossing the Line. Scorpion Steel, Jake, and Ecstasy. It's a four-way. It'll be insane. Also on that night at Crossing the Line, Carney Craig and CJ Profit do battle mano a mano one-on-one.
Mix it up. It's going to be a good one.
And at Crossing the Line, you will see the loudmouth Big Shot Khabibo versus the technical wizard Michael Nothing.
Oh, that's one you don't want to miss.
Okay, we're on television. You like the new font? You like the editing styles? Well, you can see the TV times right there on your screen right now. Write them down for your area. Share them with friends and family and people on MySpace. Speaking of MySpace, we're on MySpace, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter. We're all over the place. Plus, watch live one-hour show. Oh, not live. One-hour shows whenever you want. TWFWrestling.net. Oh, wait. What's she doing here?
Now, Crystal's in the ring. What's she doing?
Oh! Double stomp on Crystal!
Just a little bit. Honestly, it's for your own safety, because I don't know if this thing's going to stay up there. Just to let everybody know, if we had shopped at the place that I wanted to shop at, we wouldn't have this concern, but it was his idea to save money. I'm good at saving money. This thing's going to stay up. Look at that. It up, baby. And I told you it's gonna stay. I told you it's gonna stay. Stop it. I went, yes. Big lots it is, buddy. Big lots it is.
Vortex told you.
You like it?
Yeah.
You like it?
One more row back right here, please. Right here, over here, right here. Going to yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have goosebumps the size of this building. The first participant is the man that won the only previous scaffold match in the history of this company.
And he picked the number one draw. That's a formidable task. He's the first person, or one of the first people, that's going to be in this scaffold match.
This, my friends, is a match of matches. This, my friends... Oh. Yes, careers will be shortened here tonight. Lives will be changed forever. That unforgiving structure on the side of the ring there. Good God.
so damn big it takes him 10 minutes just to climb to the top.
And not only is there one here on the side of the ring that Sick Case has climbed halfway up, you see behind the ring there is a second scaffold. Oh.
Double the fun, double the pain.
Team Bala versus Team Vortex.
Contestant number dose.
It is only fitting that Raz Rhino is the second man in the ring. It is only fitting because Sick Case and Raz Rhino fought last time in the epic scaffold match.
I need water after that.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for the main event of the evening, scheduled as an eight-man War Games Elimination scaffold match. Team Bolivar versus Team Vortex. The winning team's commissioner will get to book next month's live show. We're going to start off with two wrestlers, and a new man will enter every 2 minutes. The first man was determined by coin flip earlier today. Introducing your first combatant, representing Team Bala Ball, he is Sick Case.
Well, here we go. As explained by Dick Pearsall moments ago, this is a War Games style match. Two men from opposing teams start. Every few minutes, a new man runs out from a different team. There was a coin toss earlier today to determine which team would have the one-up man. Oh. And yes, it is a scaffold match. We cannot have, it is elimination style. There will be no pinfalls or submissions until all eight men have entered this matchup. Shoots him in now, clothesline misses. Oh, leg lariat right across the jawbone.
This is gonna be good, but you called it. These guys cannot lose until all the remaining members of this scaffold match are in the ring.
Therefore, it's become a marathon match for these two. Oh, nice exploder suplex by Raz Rhino. These two battled in the summer of 2007 in the first ever scaffold match. Oh, but tonight the stakes are much crazier. It's Team Bala versus Team Vortex, and it's an eight-man tag team elimination War Games match.
And you know each of our co-commissioners are dying to have their team win this match tonight.
Definitely so. Whoever wins, oh, look at those shots. Whatever commissioner's team wins, he gets to book the entire live show. Oh, man, what a clothesline. All the matches at the next TWF Live Wrestling Show. We're talking June 20th at the Colonial Theater. We'd love to see you all there. Raz in a very compromising position now as Commissioner Vortex and Commissioner Bala look on.
Damn right. This is kind of the survival section of this. You don't want to be killed too early in the match. And these two right now are going at each other tooth and nail.
A beautiful reversal by Raz. Puts all his body weight onto Sick Case. He couldn't go for a cover there, though, since these are the only two that have started this thing.
There you go. Very smart. Try to soften up your opponent.
Definitely so. You get some of your own strength back and soften up the other guy with the submission. Raz, former TWF champion, as is Sick Case. And and it looks like Team Bala has the one-man advantage. Oh, well, CJ Profit, posturing on the ring apron, took a shot from Raz, but he's at a 2-1 disadvantage right now.
Kind of a young wrestler's mistake, took his eye off the ball, is paying for it.
Nice fisherman suplex, dumps him down on his skull, but Raz, as it stands right now, the numbers game is not in favor of Team Vortex. What a shot between the legs.
You called it, he should have just pay attention to one guy and then turn your attention to the other guy. He didn't, and now he's getting set up for a little bit of tandem offense.
Oh, boy. Oh. CJ Profit just puts a knee into the face of Raz Rhino as he's in the electric chair position by Sick Case. Crazy, crazy tandem offense by Team Bala.
Very nicely done, and CJ Profit's following up on it.
Oh, we've seen him do this before. Oh, beautiful neck breaker executed by the innovative man that we call CJ Profit, and now Sick Case trying to humiliate Raz.
And here's where that coin toss comes into play. So important. You get that one extra man, and look at, they're taking full advantage of it.
Well, the next participant to come out will be a member of Team Vortex. Oh, man. But how much? How much of Raz Rhino will be left after this two-on-one onslaught? This annihilation. Look at this. Oh, knee to the skull, and down he went like a ton of bricks.
Still more offense. Oh, wow.
And Raz is being stretched out. Raz is being absolutely killed by Sick Case and CJ Profit, two men who know how to dish it out times 100.
And you saw Commissioner Ball up on the apron over there encouraging his boys on.
Well, Raz now, slingshot position. Oh, maybe not. With the Boston Crab. Ball and leg drop, CJ Profit. Oh, no. From both sides, Dick.
This is bad. Oh, and you got to say to yourself, oh, how much can Raz take after this?
Well, he can be stretched out all night. He can't tap out until all the participants have entered the ring. This is not good for the anatomy of Raz or for the team of Vortex.
You're damn right, because as soon as that fresh man comes in, here he is.
It's Anthrax. Oh, and like a house on fire, in comes Anthrax and evens the odds at 2-on-2 in this scaffold match, in this 8-man elimination match. Here he goes. Oh, leg lariat, and Sick Case goes down.
That's exactly what he needed to do, was get in there and clean house, and that's exactly what he did do.
Well, if it wasn't for the entrance of Anthrax moments ago, Raz Rhino's career might be done, because how long can one guy get beat down by two? Numbers games were not in the advantage of Vortex. However, it's even at 2-on-2 now, but when the next participant comes out, he obviously will be a member of Team Bala Ball, and that does not favor Vortex. Oh, nice spine buster.
So it's up to Anthrax right now to really pour on the offense.
Definitely so. Raz is on the top rope.
He's back.
Oh, big scary elbow from Raz.
Right into the chest of Sick Case.
Well, it's about beating guys down right now. It's about punishing them as much as you can. Beautiful, nice neck breaker. Returns the favor. As you see on the top side of your screen there, there's the big elbow. You're live on the bottom right. I still can't get over there's two scaffolds out there.
Insane, yet to take any plate. Oh, huge clothesline.
Well, Sick Case, being the veteran that he was, uses that power, uses that smash mouth offense to get the advantage back on Anthrax. There's no pinfall at this juncture, Sick Case.
He's got him pinned, though.
Well, that's your instinct as a wrestler. If you hit a big, heavy move, you go for a cover. I mean, that's the way these guys were trained, the way they've been functioning for years. But pinfalls or submissions mean nothing at this juncture as he lays into Anthrax with these shots.
Enormous right hands. Look at that, just absolutely collapsing the body of Anthrax.
Well, at one time, those two, Anthrax and Sick Case, were tag team champions of this promotion. Oh, big clothesline by Raz on CJ. There's a lot of history, a lot of men whose lives have wound in and out of each other over the years in this matchup. Vortex has got an earful for Sick Case. Russian leg sweep by Raz.
co-commissioners, John with each other, John with the wrestlers. I love it.
Oh, well, it was a real mania several months ago that a decision was made that Vortex became the co-commissioner with Johnny Ballaball Williams. Since that day, those two have not got along at all. Oh, knee right to the cheekbone, and Raz is hurt. So this is what it's come to. After a five-year hiatus, Murph is back in TWF. He's a former TWF champion, left the company with tons of heat from just about everyone. Everyone on the roster hated his guts, but he has found his way in this main event, and he's stomping a hole in Anthrax.
But you gotta ask yourself, how much is that time off gonna affect Murph? Well, we'll find out during this match. Oh!
Pile driver on the far side of the ring there by CJ Profit onto Raz. Meanwhile, here's Murph. Oh, Vader bomb, and Anthrax is in trouble. And here we go with the numbers game one more time. Three men are out there for Team Bala, and only two for Team Vortex.
Here we go. Can they take advantage? It looks like they can right now.
Raz definitely in trouble. Murph smells the blood like a shark smelling bloody water. Oh, that'll rearrange your facial features in a hurry.
They're not done yet.
Side effect by Murph, one of his trademark moves there. Raz and Anthrax are having their butts handed to him. No fancy way to put that.
Hell yeah, and you gotta remember that Raz has been out there since the beginning of this match.
Oh, Ram Jam fails to find the mark. Raz with instinct moves out of the way, but it's not enough to clear an offensive path for him at this moment. Meanwhile, Anthrax has somewhat recovered on the far side. There's a drop kick and a back elbow. Oh, that's what?
The next contestant, Corey
Oh, and in comes a man with more charisma than Liberace and Muhammad Ali combined. It's Carney Craig, and he's whacking people with the pimp cane.
He had that cane, and he put it to use.
Definitely so. This is TWF. There are no disqualifications whatsoever, and Carney Craig knows that. Nice suplex, and he just injected the adrenaline needed for Team Vortex to recover from their deficit.
And he shows the shake and bake afterwards. That's the advantage of that fresh man coming in there and cleaning house.
Definitely so. Technically, though, the odds are even at three apiece right now. Three men are in the ring and battling for Team Vortex. Oh, my God, what a super kick.
Enormous.
I don't know. I don't mean to take anything away from your boy Ecstasy, but... Oh, good God. That might be the best super kick in the world.
It's a damn good super kick, but it's not an uber kick.
Oh, really?
Damn right. Look at this, though. Murph in some trouble.
Oh, sit out. Power bomb. Nicely done by Carney Craig. Meanwhile, Anthrax flips his way back in the ring onto the anatomy of sick case, and Team Vortex has got more momentum than a runaway freight train at this juncture in the matchup.
Says it all right there, Jacoby Jones.
Well, in comes a man that could be a difference maker right now. Joey Balls, former world champion, is the next man in this matchup. Former wrestler of the year. Oh, but look at Raz. Oh, went for that swanton and found nothing but canvas, Dick Pearsall.
Nobody home. And look at the intelligence of Joey Balls. He waits for his opportunity to get in the ring when he sees it. That's a damn lie. You'll get sued for that.
Is that slander or what?
That's complete slander. We got lawyers. Don't forget that.
We got him on speed dial. Oh, and look at Ecstasy in the front row, egging on Joey Balls. Does that say Anthrax is a big fat wiener?
It'd be true if it was, if it did.
Can we say that on TV? Meanwhile, Joey Balls, though, comes in the ring, cleans house like Alice on the Brady Bunch, and once again, Team Bala flexing their skill.
Here we go. Some very stiff slaps by Sick Case.
Here's Raz one more time, missed the swanton. as Joey Balls was entering the ring for his team. That double dose of damage able to swing momentum back in the direction of Team Bala, and they're at full strength with all four guys.
Oh, and I've seen this. Joey Balls has the flog. Oh!
Right between the eyes. If Carney Craig goes to the emergency room, they're going to say, how'd you get that welt between your eyes?
See, a grown man hit me with a flog.
Joey Balls now has got Anthrax right where he wants him. One man left to come out for Team Vortex.
Look at the strength.
Oh, suplex. DDT drops him on his face. And look at this.
That's power, my friend.
Yeah, power personified definitely in the form of Joey Balls. Oh, throws Anthrax out of the ring like yesterday's garbage.
This is a battle royal. He'd be eliminated right now.
Yeah, definitely so, but it's not. It's a team environment. It's 4-on-4. Once the next participant, which I think you all know who it is since he's not out here yet, gets out here, then it can be pinfall or submission. It's elimination style till one team is totally gone.
Here he comes.
Oh, and talk about a man motivated. Talk about a world champion of TWF who's going to represent Team Vortex. Talk about a guy that rules this company. It's Scorpion.
Using that belt like a sledgehammer and hitting everybody in sight.
And once again, Team Vortex comes to the forefront. Team Vortex flexes their unity and their pride. I don't see Team Bala all wearing Team Bala shirts, but I see Team Vortex all with Vortex shirts on. There is a unified front for his team.
We'll see if it helps his team win this match. T-shirts, all the fancy t-shirts in the world, doesn't mean squat if you don't get the 1-2-3. Oh, look at that.
Oh, we'll see. He's getting, oh, CJ Profit getting killed with that steel chair.
Once more, Carney Craig, oh, got caught. More weapons are starting to come out right now. Vortex getting involved.
Well, pandemonium on the floor. Meanwhile, in the ring, Sick Case able to muscle over Scorpion. And now Raz choking the life out of Joey Balls on the outside as Vortex screams directions to his troops.
All wrestlers are on the outside.
Well, this, my friend. Oh, good God. Oh, and Murph. Please meet Mr. Ring Post, Murph. Pleased to meet you.
We got Ring Post. We got barbed wire bats. Broken kendo sticks. What the hell else? Oh!
Yeah, it's only a two-camera shoot, so we're going to capture everything we possibly can. Kudos to our cameraman for doing the best they can. It's an all-out brawl on the outside. Meanwhile, Joey Balls gets tossed to the inside. Murph with retaliation there on Craig.
Oh,
God! He got him right between the eyes with that damn barbed wire baseball bat. Got ourselves an old-fashioned standoff on the outside. Tara now is in the ring. So pinfalls or submissions do count now, and men will be eliminated if that happens. Big swing and a miss. Oh! And once again, that super kick.
Caught.
Oh!
Not today.
Damn it, that was close. I thought Joey Balls was done. Well, there's that chair shot one more time. Meanwhile, Team Vortex are all back in the ring. Team Bala are destroyed on the outside with the exception of Joey Balls, and he's getting stomped.
Damn it. He's in no man's land, a place you don't want to be.
Hey, that's more than just a stomp. That's a god stomp. Haha, bringing it back.
Going old school on us for those TWFers who still remember.
Now it's CJ Profit's turn to get stomped into oblivion. Get him, Team Vortex. After tons of roadblocks early, after tons of trouble, after that one-man disadvantage several times in the first several minutes, Team Vortex is killing them now.
Scorpion Anthrax setting up for something here.
Oh, big power bomb. beautiful leapfrog leg drop, and Anthrax and Scorpion at one time were tag team champions of TWF as well. Oh, wait a second.
What is that?
Oh, Sick Case has got that guitar. Is he a guitar hero?
He is going to be a guitar hero.
Oh, and he broke it on the skull of Raz. Look at this.
Broken in half. One shot. And there it goes.
He broke it on Raz's skull, and that's not rubber, people. That's harder than a rock. Oh, what a suplex by Sick Case, one of his specialties.
Crazy.
Look at that, right on his skull, and Raz is definitely hurting.
Damn right, the key is taking advantage now.
I think CJ Profit's busted open on the far side of the ring. Meanwhile, Joey Balls has Anthrax in a very rough position.
Oh, yes.
That is how you break ribs right there. Joey Balls destroys Anthrax with that press slam onto that sawhorse.
And look at Joey Balls, the crown jewel of TWF, walking around like he owns the ring, because I guarantee right now he does.
Oh, no.
Zangief!
Twisting, spinning pile driver spikes him like a Southern Pacific Railroad spike, and Joey Balls is annihilating. He's killing guy after guy. Oh, but Scorpion's had enough. Big time spear, and now right hands to the skull of Joey Balls. He did not forget about Modesto. Last week on TV, Scorpion Pearl Harbored, attacked from behind by Joey Balls, and Scorpion remembers that.
He's trying to get a little payback now. Meanwhile,
fancy sauce.
Oh.
Barney Craig calls it fancy sauce, but look at this. Oh, Anthrax could have broken ribs. Oh, Raz could have a broken neck. Back to live action now, and all eight men have seen their fair share of punishment. All eight men have been going at it tooth and nail. Some of these guys, though, like Raz and Sick Case, have been in there since this thing started. They've got to be feeling it right about... who's that climbing?
Someone's going up.
That's Anthrax. Anthrax is climbing the damn scaffold.
The first wrestler to ascend the scaffold is Anthrax. What's he got in mind?
I have no idea, but Anthrax is climbing to the top of that 20-foot evil structure. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Looks like a dot up there, he's so high.
Oh my God. Oh, did you see that?
Life and limb is taken in hand. Anthrax takes out everybody.
The flip from the top of a 20-foot scaffold. The dive, the swanton, the beel, whatever the hell you want to call it. That man just put life and limb on the line to take out Team Bala. Oh, no.
Joey Balls has a chair. Oh, and you know bad things are going to happen after that.
And parts the skull of Carney Craig with that chair. Damn it. You do not want a powerful man like that swinging a steel chair at you anytime in your damn life.
He'll bend that steel chair in half over someone's head.
Definitely so. Oh, and speaking of bending it in half, that's exactly what he did moments ago on the TWF champion Scorpion.
Are you kidding me? That's gotta kill Scorpion. Look at that shot.
Joey Balls has Scorpion's number right now. Meanwhile, Murph takes a DDT on his skull. Oh, but there's Joey Balls.
Once more.
Oh, and down goes Raz as well. That chair has been a very potent weapon.
Hell yeah, he's using that chair like an usher at a wedding. Amazing.
Oh, incredible. Oh.
It takes him almost 2 seconds just to get to the ground.
A 20-foot dive moments ago by Anthrax. If you're just joining us, you missed a hell of a match so far. Anthrax dove off a damn 20-foot scaffold, but here we are. There's eight men. It's an elimination match. It's Team Bala versus Team Vortex. It's a scaffold match. You see one scaffold behind the ring, one scaffold on the camera left side of the ring, but what's happening in it?
We got the makeshift table set up.
Oh!
Splinter City!
A bloody CJ Profit just took out Carney Craig. Pepsi Plunge, Pedigree, whatever the hell you want to call it, it stuck him through a table.
Amazing. Can they take advantage? No one has yet to be eliminated from this match.
Carney Craig could be number one right now. Oh! What guts and heart to kick out of that thing.
This match could go on all night. These guys all have heart.
Yeah, well, I might not like some of their attitudes, but you have to agree that all eight men are giving you their damn souls here tonight in this crazy, life-altering environment.
Russian leg sweep by Murph.
Yep, and Scorpion now to his feet, taking out his frustrations on a bloody CJ Profit.
Find someone on the opposing team and start pounding on him.
Definitely so. And down goes CJ.
Opponents are not hard to find in this match.
You got more lumber being brought in the ring by, I have no idea by who, but like this match needed any, oh! That's for quitting on the internet. Holy moly!
What a shot.
Well, the co-commissioner just showed Murph what he thinks of him. When Murph first came back at Realmania, we all thought that he would be on the right side of the tracks, if you know what I'm saying. We thought he'd be an honorable individual. Instead, though, he decided to try to run with Sick Case and Bala Ball.
Nothing wrong with that. Pick the winning side.
Oh, really?
You're damn right.
Well, that's yet to be proven.
We'll see.
Oh, superplex by the TWF champion Scorpion onto CJ Profit. You see Joey Balls plotting something on the stage now. Sick Case is on the top rope.
Joey Balls, like the ring generally is. Meanwhile, nobody home.
A moonsault fails to find its target, and down goes Sick Case.
Joey Balls back in there with that barbed wire baseball bat.
And what does that feel like swung on your spine?
Baseball bat would be bad enough. Barbed wire would be bad enough. Mix them together, and this is what you get.
Oh, good God.
Raking across the face.
And Scorpion, oh, has been busted open, has been sliced open, has been lacerated by that man right there.
And look at this, putting the barbed wire any place on his body and just crushing down on it.
Well, there's that crazy pedigree. Oh, one more time off the damn top. All these guys are showing the world that they've got the guts and tenacity to hang in this ultra-violent TWF environment here tonight. Oh, wait a second.
What's going on?
Carney Craig just placed a chair on CJ Profit, who's a little too incapacitated to get it off of him. Well, this is the first we've seen of this other scaffold.
Something new to our scaffold match. Another scaffold, not quite as tall, but still very, very, very dangerous.
Oh, no. Oh, what an elbow.
Damn.
CJ Profit has been eliminated. CJ Profit just took the most gigantic, monstrous elbow I've ever seen in my life, and now Oh, no. Oh, and to put the icing on the cake, CJ Asshole, as the fans call him, just took a tombstone on the ground.
He's already been eliminated. What the hell is Scorpion doing?
And now Murph just propels his own body into that of Carney Craig, and now Scorpion taking out the trash that we call CJ.
Damn.
And Team Vortex has a 4-on-3 advantage at this juncture in the matchup. Definitely to their advantage. CJ eliminated.
That is big. One extra man.
Oh, sit out pedigree by Murph on Carney Craig.
Murph is looking like $1 million. You can't even tell he had any kind of ring layoff.
Definitely so. I'm not sure what Scorpion's thinking. He's got a ladder here on the floor. You've got action on the inside as well. This is TWF. Accept no substitutes for the insanity you see on your television screen. Thank you so much for watching. Murph, though, I think he's thinking of climbing that thing.
He's going up. We've got ladders. We've got scaffolds. We've got lumber chairs, barbed wire bats. This match has absolutely been one of the greatest matches so far this year.
Match of the year candidate times 100, but wait a second. Murph is on top of that scaffold.
Oh no, what's he have in mind?
And look at the sick case. Dumps him down on the canvas.
Setting him up.
Murph barking directions.
Wow.
Well, Anthrax swooped in a little bit too late, and Carney Craig eliminated after that spectacular elbow moments ago, and we're even. It's three guys against three guys here tonight, Team Bola versus Team Vortex.
Down to the final six. Match once again even.
And Murph, oh so proud of himself. Yeah, fine. To view it one more time. Wow.
Awesome elbow.
Meanwhile, though, Scorpion has that ladder ominously placed. Oh, a sick case eats another ladder. Scorpion and Anthrax moving stuff around like they work at Home Depot.
Moving stuff around like he's a Beacon's moving man. What's he have in mind? Setting up something crazy and ominous, no doubt.
Oh, and Murph goes straight south, pile driver.
Worth another look.
Definitely so, and now Scorpion and Anthrax are setting up some sort of table. Meanwhile, Murph, though, trying to swing back, trying to get those lefts into the head. He's a southpaw.
Murph, the best on earth, as he likes to call himself. He's actually doing great right now, taking on 2 men at one time.
Well, I can't say he's a slouch. Murph has all the ability in the world. However, after a 5-year hiatus in TWF, Murph took a shortcut and tried to join up with Sick Case and Balla Ball. He's on. Oh boy. Scorpion wasn't softened up enough, and now he's climbing that ladder, coming after Murph.
He went for the world champ. He thought he had him softened up enough where he could make a high-impact maneuver across those boards, but no such luck. Now he's in no man's land.
Definitely so. When you're both on a ladder like that, I think the stronger guy is going to win the power struggle. And Scorpion, there might not be anyone stronger than him. Oh, no.
Oh! Stuck it.
Murph has been eliminated in spectacular fashion. That Joker's Wild, that crazy drop you on your head maneuver from Scorpion did away with Murph, and here we go.
Joey Balls getting back into the action.
Well, ever the opportunist Joey Balls, after Scorpion took out Murph in spectacular fashion, Joey Balls takes out Scorpion for the time being, and now he's got Anthrax right where he wants him, positions him on the top rope.
No doubt, Joey Ball's the smartest wrestler in this match.
On my estimation, is it 3-on-2? I think it's Sick Case and Joey Balls. Speaking of balls, wow.
Amazing.
What unbelievable athleticism displayed by that man. For a man that big and powerful to execute a flawless Hurricane Rana, only two.
Strength and agility, that is Joey Balls.
Tremendous athlete. I will give him that. Tremendous, amazing. Once in a lifetime kind of athlete. He just has an attitude that's worth about 2 cents.
Hey, that's your opinion.
He's just more self-centered than Paris Hilton.
Hey, he gave me a birthday card this year.
Same goes for Sick Case. Oh no. Well, Scorpion able to wiggle his way out of trouble. Tombstone!
Oh, right in the center of the ring.
Tombstone, beautiful reversal by Scorpion, but not enough left in the gas tank to pin him. Oh, that was crazy. Wow. Meanwhile, Sick Case and Joey Balls working together to set up another piece of lumber in the ring here in the scaffold match. Oh, wait.
Sick Case is pointing it.
Oh, we've seen this before. Raz and Sick Case participated in the only other scaffold match in TWF history. It was a one-on-one match for the TWF Championship in August of 2007, and history is repeating itself here and now.
Here they are, meeting at the top.
Oh my God, my goosebumps are huge. That is two men. Two men on the top of a 20-foot scaffold.
It looks like Sick Case taking advantage, getting the punches in, softening up Raz. Oh no. Oh my God!
He's dead. He is dead. And Raz, oh my God. And Raz has been eliminated in the craziest thing I've ever seen in my life. That was a psycho driver of a 20-foot scaffold.
Did you see his body bounce after it hit the ring?
I am serious as a heart attack. That was the craziest thing I've ever seen in my life. Oh my God.
Raz being taken to the back by Vortex.
And he did not leave under his own power. That is not a good sign. Oh my God.
That, I'm speechless.
Oh, did you see him bounce off the canvas? That was, bar none, the craziest thing I've ever seen in my life.
Wow.
I've been doing this a long time, and sometimes certain moments just speak for themselves. Sometimes certain moments, transcend this wrestling business we're in. Oh, well, Joey Balls sees an opportunity and hits amp. I'm still tripping. I don't know.
Man, that was a spectacular scaffold match moment.
Definitely so. And when the smoke clears on the craziest thing I've ever seen in my life, it looks like it's Joey Balls and Sick Case versus Anthrax and Scorpion. 2-on-2. Elimination.
Right now we got a numbers game. 2-on-1 against Joey Balls.
Well, how much did that crazy psycho driver off that 20-foot scaffold take out a Sick Case too?
You gotta think of that.
Definitely so. I mean, Sick Case was the one delivering the move. He was able to pin Raz Rhino afterwards, but how much did it take out of him as well? Joey Balls might be the proverbial sitting duck with Anthrax and Scorpion both going after him.
Joey Balls trying to clear the cobwebs, trying to pump himself up, maybe try to get a reversal out of this.
Oh, no reversal in sight. Overhead belly-to-belly suplex, nicely executed by Scorpion.
Damn it.
Oh, pops those hips and drops him down.
Oh, man, this doesn't look good for my man Joey Balls right now.
Oh, wow. Canadian Destroyer, tainted package, flipping pile driver through that lumber.
Right now, Team Vortex sitting in the driver's seat.
Definitely so. Scorpion and Anthrax are throwing everything but the kitchen sink at Joey Balls. Well, here we go. Look at the replay. Boom. It was Joey Balls' skull that broke the lumber. It was the head, the cranium of Joey Balls that went through that thing, and now he's being stretched out. Sick Case trying to still clear the cobwebs on the outside.
Oh, Sick Case is out of it. He is done like last night's dinner. Meanwhile,
at this juncture in the match, this is a smart move for the champion, Scorpion. Meanwhile, Vortex trying to pump some blood, pump some life into Anthrax, who's already dove off this scaffold here tonight.
Vortex, Scorpion bringing Joey Balls up to a vertical base.
Oh, and boots him right on the jawbone.
Damn.
There's that crazy tainted package one more time. Meanwhile, though, while we were replaying that, Joey Balls was able to get the advantage back on Scorpion, and things do not look good as Sick Case is regaining his senses coming in.
Here we go, back to a 2-on-2.
Definitely so. Anthrax needs to stick and move in this environment. Anthrax.
Huge clubbing blows by both men beating down Anthrax. What do they have in mind?
Well, some sort of double team move. Anthrax trying to fight it with all he's got.
Oh,
folded up like a damn report card. Folded up like a piece of paper. Tandem offense, tandem power, double team from hell, and Anthrax is not moving.
Joey Ball's going for the submission hold.
Oh no, and Anthrax has got nowhere to go. He's got no one to help him. Scorpion being manhandled on the far side by Sick Case, and now Joey Balls squeezing on Anthrax.
It could be a tap or snap situation.
Oh, he's got too far to go.
Wrenching on that arm, right there it is.
Damn. And Joey Balls has just made Anthrax tap out. You're stretched for that long. Your body reaches a certain level of pain, and you can't take any. Look at this. Oh, knocked him silly with that tandem powerbomb, and then nowhere to go. Tap or snap, as my broadcast colleague said, and Anthrax is eliminated.
Here we go. You got to say advantage, ball a ball.
Well, as it stands here and now, as Joey Balls and Scorpion are both climbing the 20-foot scaffold, as it stands right now, Scorpion is a lone man. Scorpion is a man unto himself, a one-man island, because Scorpion is the only guy left for Team Vortex, and Joey Balls and Sick Case have yet to be eliminated from Team Balla. Oh, God.
And that is two very large men up there, too.
Definitely so. Both guys swinging at each other's faces with rights. Joey Balls and Scorpion are on top of that scaffold, and I have no idea what's going to happen. That is a 20-foot structure that they're battling on top of.
Straight down to nothing but the mat.
Oh, God. And Scorpion, the first to his feet. This could become a huge advantage.
Oh, no.
Oh, wait. Was that a low blow?
I think I saw a low blow.
Joey Balls low blowed him.
Can he gain back the advantage?
Oh my.
Has been eliminated. The match is over.
Oh my God. Chokeslam. Chokeslam. Chokeslam of a 20-foot scaffold, and Joey Balls just pinned Scorpion, and Team Bala is victorious here tonight. Sick Case and Joey Balls are the survivors. Look at this. Oh! The human body cannot take that. And Scorpion out cold. Out cold after that choke slam, and Team Bala is here to celebrate. My God. Sports? What? Oh, damn it. I thought for a split second that Sick Case had some sportsmanship in him, but hell no. They just used this, oh, and here comes Vortex. They're using this opportunity to kill this guy. Team Bala and their, oh, here comes Rufio. Oh, damn it. There's just too many of them. After being victorious in the scaffold match, Team Bala has gone on to destroy everything in their... Oh! And there is nothing but broken bodies left in their wake. What can only be characterized as the most insane, crazy, unbelievable match in this promotion's history, those guys triumph. Come on! Is this necessary? Oh! Vortex has a bad heart!
It looks like I made the right choice here! It also looks like I get to book the next show!
I cannot even glorify this with
any. I just want everybody to look at what's left of Team Vortex right now. Look at it. Nothing but chips of wood and a beaten, battered motherfucker right here.
Fuck your heart.
Back up, little kid! Mom, we're not playing with you!
On the 18th, in 2 months, I can't book this show, Sick Case. And it's gonna be you! In the main event! In the match of your fucking life, you stupid fuck! And you're gonna wrestle me!
No, 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 Fuck yeah! You're trying to wrestle! You don't have backers clearing!
What about your heart?
Fuck yeah!
Oh my God, did you hear that? Vortex wants to wrestle Sick Case in July.
Vortex isn't cleared medically to wrestle.
Well, come to our next live show. It is Saturday, June 20th, Colonial Theater, 3522 Stockton Boulevard in Sacramento. Boom! There will be a four-way for the title. Scorpion, Jake, Ecstasy, and Steel. Who will walk out with the strap?
That's going to be a good one.
That will be absolutely amazing. Also on tap, Carney Craig and CJ Profit just did battle in the crazy scaffold match. They duke it out one-on-one, crossing the line.
You know they got payback on their mind.
Also, Michael Nothing and Big Shot Khabibo have been signed mano-a-mano, the drunk guy versus the awesome guy.
That's the most important thing. Is Khabibo going to show up sober?
And just announced, Four Dicks Dugout, Vortex and Sick Case will sign the contracts to wrestle each other one-on-one. Fans bring the weapons for July.
You know an event like that can only be on the dugout.
You see the TV times on the screen. Sacramento, Davis, Stockton area. They're on the screen right now. TWF coming your way on TV screens all over the place. Plus, you can follow us on MySpace, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter. Watch full one-hour shows whenever you want at twfwrestling.net. That's what I do.
You're damn right. Everybody knows us in the Valley, but all around the world, that's where we're spreading the news.
Okay, well, crossing the line, it's June 20th, Colonial Theater, 3522 Stockton Boulevard in Sacramento. Doors at 7, bell time at 7:30. You have got to show up for our live pro wrestling. We do whatever we can, as, you know, illustrated in that last scaffold match. We will do whatever we can to make it an awesome experience for you. You got 5 seconds, Dick Pearsall. I'll give you the last word.
Man, what a match. Insane.